Hello and welcome to Deep Dive on Fight for Liberty. In this episode, we're covering the Ban Conflicted Trading Act. This act, originally presented in May of 2019 by Representative Jeff Merkley of Oregon, has gotten new popularity in the wake of the investigation into members of Congress who allegedly used information gained in a Senate Intelligence Committee meeting on COVID-19 to get ahead of the oncoming stock market crash. This would be in direct violation of the Stock Act, which bans the practice of trading stocks based on the information gained through their work. This practice, often referred to as insider trading, which has been illegal for the general public since 1909, was finally prohibited for members of Congress in 2012 upon passing the Stop Trading on Congressional Knowledge, or Stock Act. Some members of Congress and the public did not believe the Stock Act went far enough, and thus the Ban Conflicted Trading Act was born. As we dive into this bill, Section 1, as always, just names the bill. Section 2 delves into a few definitions. The important ones to note are covered investment, which is a security, commodity, or future. Basically, anything you could make money off of that could affect your job. Next is a covered person, which is any sitting member of Congress or any officer or employee of Congress. Both definitions are taken straight out of the Ethics in Government Act of 1978. Section 3 executes the objective of the bill quite quickly and simply by prohibiting any member of Congress or any covered person from purchasing or selling any covered investment or entering into a transaction that would result in owning a covered investment. It also prohibits any covered person from serving as an officer or member of any board of any nonprofit association, corporation, or other entity. I'm not sure how I feel about that last bit. I'm okay with politicians having a career outside of Washington. But Section 4 eases up the restrictions with a few exceptions. Subsection A talks about investments held before taking office, and Subsection B talks about divestiture, giving members of Congress a six-month period after either taking office or the enactment of the bill to sell any covered investments that they might want to offload. Now, Section 5 deals with blind trusts. It gives the Select Committee on Ethics the power to review trusts on a case-by-case basis, according to, again, the Ethics in Government Act of 1978. Section 6 deals with the administration and enforcement. It gives the Select Committees on Ethics of the Senate and the Committee on Ethics of the House of Representatives authorization to issue guidance on any matter contained in this act. It then levels a civil penalty of not less than 10% of the value of the covered investment. For most people taking part in this, 10% might not be enough of a deterrent, and I think it's a weak penalty for what should be illegal. Nevertheless, I see the Ban Conflicted Trading Act as a step in the right direction, and even AOC is getting in on the action. She said in a press release that members of Congress should not be allowed to buy and sell individual stock. We are here to serve the public, not to profiteer. And I couldn't agree more. Politics should not be seen as a lifelong career or a get-rich-quick scheme. It should be viewed as a public service opportunity, a way to give back to your community and work in their best interests, not your own. Many other politicians have spoken out in recent months about this profiteering mindset in Washington, including Tulsi Gabbard, Justin Amash, Thomas Massey, and Ilhan Omar. It's also being talked about by constituents more regularly, and I believe the winds of change are upon Washington. This bill is a big step towards getting money out of politics and returning to clean, honest representation. Thanks for watching Deep Dive, and until next time, welcome to the fight.